Hello, and welcome to the finals edition of APE News on Channel 4. I'm Megan Pate.
And I'm Natalie Reamy.
Today we're going to discuss the parallels between the plays Death of a Salesman and Oedipus Rex. The first and noticeable parallel between the plays is they begin in media res. In Death of a Salesman, readers are informed about Willie's affair until the middle of the plays. In Oedipus Rex, readers do not learn of Oedipus's highway encounter until Antistrophe 2, Scene 2. Both plays are considered tragedies because they parallel these six guidelines. The first characteristic is seen through nobility because in a tragedy, a hero must be considered of noble stature. He is great with outstanding qualities.
Hi, I'm Andrea.
And I'm Sierra.
Although Willie is not rich or of loyal stature, his family still considers him noble. Willie is proud of his work, so therefore his family is too. He considers himself one of the best salesman personalities around. As a youngster, Biff is proud of his dad.
Everybody wave when Biff comes out on the field.
Thanks, Pa.
You set now, Buck?
Ready to go, Pa. Every muscle's ready.
You realize what this means?
That's right, Pa.
You coming home this afternoon, captain of the All-Scholastic Champion Team of the City of New York.
I got it, Pop. And remember, pal, when I take off my helmet, that touchdown's for you.
In Oedipus Rex, Oedipus is clearly a noble hero. He has defeated the Sphinx and agrees to help rule the city of Thebes.
Great Oedipus, O powerful king of Thebes, you see how all the people cling to your altar steps. Here are the boys who can barely stand alone, and here are the priests by the weight of age, as am I, a priest of God, and young men chosen from those yet unmarried. As for the others, all the multitude, they wait with the olive chaplets in the squares, and at the shrines of Pallas, and where Apollo speaks in the glowing embers.
Besides the protagonists, some of the minor characters parallel nobility as well. A major parallel between Linda and Jocasta. Throughout each play, both mothers act as mediators and caregivers. Linda defends her husband's honor when she scolds the boys' careless remarks.
Then make Charlie your father, Biff. You can't do that, can you? Willie Loman never made a lot of money. His name was never in the paper. He's not the finest character that ever lived. But he's a human being, and a terrible thing is happening to him. So attention must be paid. He's not allowed to fall into his grave like an old dog. Attention. Attention must finally be paid to such a person. You called him crazy.
I didn't mean to...
No! A lot of people think he's lost his balance, but you don't have to be very smart to know what his trouble is. The man is exhausted.
Sure he is.
A small man can be just as exhausted as a great man. He works for a company 36 years this March, opens up unheard of territories for their trademark, and now in his old age, they take his salary away?
I didn't know that, Mom.
You never asked, my dear. Now that you get your spending money someplace else, you don't trouble your mind with him.
See here, Jocasta tries to keep Oedipus' mind at rest and to ease him of his worries.
In God's name, Oedipus, inform your wife as well. Why are you so set in this hard anger?
I will tell you, for none of these men deserves my confidence as you do. It is Creon's work, his treachery, his plotting against me.
Go on, if you can make this clear to me.
He charged me with the murder of Laios.
He has some knowledge, or does he speak from hearsay?
He would not commit himself to such a charge, but he's brought in that damnable soothsayer to tell his story.
Set your mind at rest. If it is a question of soothsayers, I tell you that you will find no man whose craft gives knowledge of the unknowable.
However, as the play progresses, both women experience denial of their husband's actions. Here, we see that Linda has found the rubber pipe, but instead of confronting Willie, she pretends it is unimportant.
Well, it seems she was walking down the road and saw his car. She said that he wasn't driving fast at all, and that he didn't skid. She says he came to that little bridge and then deliberately smashed into the railing, and it was only the shallowness of the water that saved him.
No, he probably just fell asleep again, Mom.
I don't think he fell asleep.
Why not?
Last month... Oh, boys, it's so hard to say a thing like this. He's just a big, stupid man to you. But I tell you, there's more good in him than many other people. I was looking for a fuse. The lights blew out, and I went down to the cellar. And behind the fuse box, it happened to fall out, was a length of rubber pipe, just short.
No kidding.
There's a little attachment on the end of it. I knew right away. And sure enough, on the bottom of the water heater, there's a new little nipple on the gas pipe.
That jerk!
Did you have it taken off?
I'm ashamed to. How can I mention to him? Every day I go down and take away that little rubber pipe. But when he comes home, I put it back where it was. How can I insult him that way?
When Jocasta begins to realize Oedipus may be her son, she does not reveal it to him, but rather keeps it to herself, which leads to her downfall.
Forget this, herdsman! Forget it all! This talk is a waste of time!
How can you say that when the clues to my true birth are in my hands?
For God's love, let us have no more questioning! It is your life. Is your life nothing to you? My own is pain enough for me to bear.
You need not worry. Suppose my mother is a slave, and born of slaves. No baseness can touch you.
Listen to me! I beg you, do not do this thing!
I will not listen! The truth must be made known.
Everything that I say is for your own good!
My own good snatch my patience, then. I want none of it.
You are fatally wrong! May you never learn who you are!
Now, coming back to the main tragic characteristics. We know that the main character, the hero, must be noble and right. But of course, everyone has a flaw. This flaw usually leads to their hamartia, or an act of injustice.
Willie and Oedipus are no exception. Although the two men aspire to be like Ben and Creon, their faults remain. Willie and Oedipus are both faulty with obsession. Willie is obsessed with his job and of being successful.
If I had $40 a week, that's all I need. $40, Howard.
I can't take blood from a stone.
Howard, the year Al Smith was nominated, your father came to me and he said, basically...
I've gotta see some people, kid.
I'm talking about your father. They were promises made across this desk. You mustn't tell me you've got people to see. I put 34 years into this firm, Howard, and now I can't pay my insurance. You can't eat the orange and throw the peel away. Your father, in 1928, had a big year. I averaged $170 a week alone in commissions.
No, Willie, you never average.
I averaged $170 a week in a year in commissions. And your father came to me, or rather, I was in the office here. It was right over this desk. And he put his hand on my shoulder.
You'll have to excuse me, Willie. I gotta see some people. Pull yourself together.
Pull myself together? What the hell did I say to him? My God, I was yelling at him. How could I? Frank, don't you remember what you told me that time? How you put my hand on your shoulder? Frank!
New York is Albany, the capital of Ohio is Cincinnati, the capital of Rhode Island is Providence.
Howard, come in here right now!
What happened?
Shut it off! I gotta get myself some coffee. I'll get some coffee.
Willie, look.
I'll go to Boston.
Willie, you can't go to Boston.
Why can't I go?
I don't want you to represent us. I've been meaning to tell you for a long time now.
Howard, are you firing me?
I think you need a good long rest.
Oedipus is obsessed with finding the truth and of slipping out of fate's grasp.
I went to the shrine at Delphi. The god dismissed my question without reply. He spoke of other things. Some were clear, full of wretchedness, dreadful, unbearable, as that I should like with my own mother breed children from whom all men would turn their eyes, and that I should be my father's murderer. I heard all this and fled. And from that day, Corinth to me was only in the stars, descending in that quarter of the sky, as I wandered farther and further on my way to a land where I should never see the evil sung by the oracle.
These two characters also contain the flaw of pride. Each thinks of himself as the highest and mightiest. Willie believes he is the best salesman and irreplaceable.
Aren't you going to end? Aren't you going to answer the door? You'll wake the whole hotel.
I'm not expecting anybody.
Why don't you have another drink, honey? And stop being so damn self-centered.
But I'm so lonely.
You know you ruined me, Willie. From now on, whenever you come to the office, I'll see that you go right through to the buyers. No waiting at my desk anymore, Willie. You ruined me.
That's nice of you to say that.
Gee, you are so self-centered. Why so sad? You're the saddest, self-centeredest, soul I ever did seesaw. Come on inside, drummer boy. It's silly. Silly to be dressing in the middle of the night. Aren't you going to answer that door?
They're knocking on the wrong door.
But I felt the knocking, and you heard us talking in here. Maybe the hotel's on fire.
It's a mistake.
Then tell him to go away.
There's nobody there.
It's getting on my nerves, Willie. There's somebody standing out there, and it's getting on my nerves.
Stay in the bathroom and don't come out. I think there's a law in Boston about it. So don't come out. It may be the new room clerk. He looked very mean. So don't come out. It's a mistake. There's no fire.
Why didn't you answer?
Biff, what are you doing in Boston?
Why didn't you answer? I've been knocking for 5 minutes. I even called you on the phone, Dad.
I just heard you. I was in the bathroom and had the door shut. Did anything happen at home?
In Oedipus Rex, Oedipus consciously murders a man, which turns out to be his father.
There are three highways coming together at a place I have, and there are heroes who are the groom leading the horses forced me off the road at his lord's command, but as his charioteer lurched forward over towards me, I struck him. I struck him in my rage. The old man saw me and got his double gout down upon my head as I came abreast. He was paid back, and more. Swinging my club in his right hand, I knocked him out of his cart and rolled on the ground. I killed him.
Characteristic of a tragedy is that the hero's downfall is his own fault, from his own free choice. This is a criminal act brought on by the hero's flaws.
This act is done by the hero's own free choice. Both of these plays have an obvious act of commercia. In Death of a Salesman, Willie cheats on his wife on his own free will.
Although the crimes of the characters are wrong and unlawful, the consequences are not wholly deserved. The punishment exceeds the crime.
As Willie's true worth of a man is fully recognized, his bonds with his boys reach a peak of instability. He is dealt another crushing blow as he is fired from his job. Although the crimes of the characters are wrong and unlawful, the consequences are not wholly deserved.
Get out of my sight!
I want to see the boss!
You're not going near him!
Where is he?
You invite him for dinner. He looks forward to it all day. And then you desert him there. There's no stranger you'd do that to.
Why? He had a soul tie with us. Listen, when I was... desert him, I hope I don't outlive the day.
Get out of here!
Now look, Mom.
Did you have to go to women tonight? You and your lousy rotten whores.
Mom, all we did was follow Biff around trying to cheer him up. Boy, what a night you gave me.
Get out of here, both of you, and don't come back. I don't want you tormenting him anymore. Go on now, get your things together. You can sleep in his apartment. And you know what? Pick up this stuff. I'm not your maid anymore. Pick it up, you bum. You're a pair of animals. Not one, not another living soul would have had the cruelty to walk out a man in a restaurant.
Is that what he said?
He didn't have to say anything. He was so humiliated, he nearly limped when he came in.
But Mom, he had a great time with—
Shut up!
You didn't even go to see if he was all right.
No, I didn't. I didn't do a damn thing. How do you like that, huh? Left him babbling in a toilet.
You lousy, you.
Now you hit it on the nose. Scum of the earth, and you're looking at it!
Get out of here!